Panzergrenadier is a German term for motorized or mechanized infantry, that is, infantry transported in combat vehicles. The term Panzergrenadier was not adopted until 1942. From 1937, infantry in panzer divisions were known as Schützen regiments. But in October of 1942, these infantry regiments were renamed as Panzergrenadier regiments as a morale boost and as a historical reference to Frederick the Great's army. The Panzergrenadier regiments are notable for their speed, mobility, and great firepower, as well as for their methods of cooperating closely with the tank regiments. On paper, a German panzer division had two Panzergrenadier regiments with four battalions. But only one battalion was equipped with armored personnel carriers, so only this battalion was able to follow and cooperate with the panzer regiment. The remaining three battalions were equipped with trucks. Panzergrenadier personnel carriers, the Sonderkraftfahrzeug, so special purpose vehicle 251, were fully armored and designed for cross-country duty, carried the assault troop into battle. 251s were the most widely produced German half-tracks of the war, with more than 15,000 vehicles and variants produced. They were used to transport a single squad of 10 Panzergrenadiers to the battlefield, protected from enemy small arms fire and with some protection from artillery fire. In addition, the standard mounting of one MG-34 or MG-42 machine gun allowed the vehicle to provide suppressive fire for the rifle squad, both while they dismounted and in combat. The armor plates were designed to provide protection against standard rifle or machine gun bullets. Positive aspects of the open top included greater situational awareness and faster exit by the infantry, as well as the ability to throw grenades and fire over the top of the fighting compartment as necessary while remaining under good horizontal cover. The downside was a major vulnerability to all types of fire. This included indirect fire from mortars and field artillery, as well as small arms fire. In combat from these vehicles, the Panzergrenadiers have become an arm which does not fight according to the frontal principles like the infantry, but one which tries to force a decision within and to the rear of the hostile positions. The squad was led by the squad leader, usually a junior NCO, who was armed with a machine pistol and was responsible for the squad to the platoon commander. On the move, he also commanded the vehicle and fired the vehicle-mounted machine gun. The driver was responsible for the care of the vehicle and expected to remain with the transport. A Panzergrenadier platoon was made up of three squads with the platoon HQ. The HQ troop consisted of a platoon commander, usually a junior officer, a driver, a radio operator, and two runners. On the move, it was usual for one man to scan the skies constantly for aircraft, while others kept a watch on both sides of the vehicle. When a platoon was driving together, close order for the convoy was usually 5 to 10 meters apart, in column or even abreast in open country. In combat, however, the gaps were extended to beyond 50 meters. If the whole battalion was deployed, the preferred formation was often at the arrowhead. On the whole, troop-carrying vehicles rarely averaged more than 30 km per hour road speed. Even under ideal conditions, a panzer division was not expected to advance more than 20 km a day. The 251 drivers were prepared to simply ignore or drive through small arms fire, but the presence of enemy artillery or anti-tank guns usually saw them seek cover. The squad's machine gunners might well engage targets on the move, as could the rest of the squad if necessary from the sides. Often, when advancing, the 251s could utilize a motorized version of fire and movement, advancing, stopping and firing to cover other half-tracks. A halted half-track provided a good firing position, but was vulnerable. As a result, it was not recommended to stop more than 20 seconds in hostile terrain. The normal dismounting procedure was via the rear of the vehicle. However, in emergencies, the squad might well jump over the side as well as out of the back. This was often performed on the move at slow speeds. Once dismounted, the Panzergrenadiers fought as normal infantry. Improvements in Soviet anti-tank defenses as the war advanced meant that the Panzergrenadiers often had to precede the tanks, or a mixed force of tanks and soldiers might move forward to clear enemy defenses. One of the most important German formations developed during the war was the Wedge. The point of the Wedge was formed by the best tanks and the sides by other tanks and self-propelled guns. When the Wedge pierced the enemy defenses, it widened the gap as it passed through. The Panzergrenadiers were then able to spread out and attack remaining areas of resistance from flanks and rear. Although the Panzergrenadiers' key role was cooperation with tanks, they could fight on their own. The very flexibility was the vital component of their nature. They could fight as infantry offensive and defensive actions, assault vital strong points and clear urban or wooden areas in which the tanks were at risk. Essentially, the Panzergrenadiers was a part of an all-arms team. Their role grew out of the German acceptance that the tank could not win battles alone. The Germans, at an early stage in the war and even before the war, understood the special weakness of the tank. Its dependency on terrain and the fact that it cannot occupy but can only strike hard and break through lines. For this reason, the actual tank force was cut down to the minimum, and the division reinforced with various other units, the most important being the Panzergrenadiers.